Today we're diving into 5 more to-do list applications that you can check out. We did our main top and best to-do list applications of the year, but these are some of the ones that didn't necessarily make that list, but are still pretty helpful and have a little bit of a different approach to many of the others that we covered before. Welcome, if you're new to Keep Productive, my name is Francesco D'Alessio, excited to have you. If you're interested, do subscribe. And if you wanna see a full list of all of the to-do list applications that we think are awesome, that we rank and rate and highly reviewed, you can check out Toolfinder in the link in description. So the first on our list here is one called Routine. Now, I love the way that Routine is designed. It is really gorgeously laid out and combines not only your tasks, but with your calendar and your notes as well. You can create pages much like you would inside of something like Notion inside of there, and also manage your to-do list for the day in a very minimal, clean looking feel. And they've got a great ability to capture as well, which is something that a lot of people do like as users of Routine. And Routine has been growing fairly routinely. It's been posting updates often, and people tend to liking how their development cycle is working. But this is great if you're looking for a something like an alternative to AkiFlow, maybe alternative to Sansama, that has a more personal daily planner approach to your to-dos. So next up is Timestripe. Now, I did a full feature and review on this a couple of years ago now, but Timestripe has continued to grow, and what their speciality is trying to think more towards not necessarily day planning, but long-term planning. So what it does quite nice is it allows you to plan some tasks for your day, but allows you to see how that correlates to your week, month, year, and 5-year goals, and keeping a sort of zoomed out approach to your task management. Now, I quite like this for personal to-dos because sometimes that's something we typically forget when we're doing our own sort of personal to-dos. We're like, what do we need to get done today? What do we need to do that? But sometimes we forget how it approaches in the long term, how some of these larger goals can be filtered down and smaller tasks can be broken out from then to help us achieve them. Sometimes we lose track of that, especially when we're managing our tasks. So Timestripe seems to be a pretty decent job of that, as well as a few of other abilities that are a bit of contrarian to some of the to-do list apps you may have seen in our other video. So number 3 is TaTask. And again, this one comes at it as a very minimal approach. It hasn't necessarily got the design, but what it's got is a different approach in terms of creating a project. So what you can do is add all of your tasks, but you can basically group tasks together and they can pop out as their own sort of list, and you can begin to complete them like you would, but the hierarchy is slightly different to what you would find in a traditional to-do list application. Now, I think this is quite nice for those who are maybe routinely adding tasks, who are web-based, and who find themselves looking for an alternative structure to do a to-do list application. This is one it's worth looking at, and it's still fairly early days, so again, much like the other two, still early days, but this one much more in the early stages. An interesting take on to-do list applications right now. Number 4 is Llama Life. Now, if you haven't heard Llama Life, it is a very neat application. What it is a Chrome extension right now that pops into this micro to-do list like experience. Now, Llama Life focuses much more on trying to do, I guess, smaller chunking items versus necessarily the big stuff. You can integrate it with Todoist and other applications, but it does come at a medium pricing for a Todoist application like this, but naturally comes from an independent developer like many of the others on the list. Llama Life is nice because you can create routines from it, but you can also basically set up this whole long list. You can add in breaks, and you can be a bit more mindful about your own personal productivity for the day. It's got timers in it. It's got some other abilities with sound and music in terms of making your experience a bit more focused. And it's a really interesting approach, and especially when it comes to real hyper-focus type activities. So Llama Life, something we reviewed here on the channel before. Need to do our re-review of it anyway soon, but I hope that the review comes in helpful when looking at it. So number 5 is Amazin Marvin. Now, you may have heard of this, and it's got a really strong community. Now, Amazin Marvin is sort of like a build your own to-do list application without necessarily the Notion-like structures. What it does essentially have a core experience, and then what you can do is add all of these abilities, like switching on abilities, like features, to really enhance it. And a lot of the features and abilities that you can switch on are correlated to productivity frameworks like GTD and other famous books and methodologies. And what's nice about that is you can really tailor the experience, your to-do experience, around that, and you can use it to sort of build your own setup that works best for you. So Amazin Marvin's been on the market for some time now, and while it's been fairly highly priced, most of these are fairly highly priced because they're more independent developers, but at the same time, it does have a good community, and a lot of people do rave about Marvin and find it to be one of those ones that once you work out how to use it and sort of set up your own layouts, then a lot of people do like that experience. So folks, hopefully you found this video helpful in finding a to-do list application. Please do let me know if you've found one, and maybe not from this list, or maybe it's from this list, in the comments below. I'd really love to hear. I'm quite nosy about what to-do list applications people use naturally, because there's so many productivity apps out there. If you're new to the channel, welcome to Keep Productive. Do subscribe. I look forward to seeing you in a future video. Thank you very much, folks, and cheerio. Thank you very much for watching today's video. If you're interested in checking out some more, you'll find them here, and also you can subscribe to as well. It'd be great to have you here to optimize your tool. And if you're interested in our new email newsletters or our Bento application, or even Toolfinder, which is a new tool that we've created to help you find the perfect productivity tool, you can find it linked in the description.